and welcome to Behind the Science, where we ask challenging questions directly to the scientists who are trying to solve today's toughest problems. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. So I've been thinking, lately I have a lot of aches and pains, and my doctors prescribe me some pain relievers to help. But I get nervous taking these medicines. How does my doctor know what the right dose is for me? How does my body really get rid of these drugs effectively? I think I need to learn a little bit more about this to make me feel confident that I can take these safely. So in this episode of Behind the Science, let's relieve this headache and go into the lab where I hope they have some experience in this pain management area. Hi, Kim.
Hi, Jen.
I was wondering if you could help me. I've had to take some pain medication lately, and I'm really worried that my body isn't removing it properly. How do I know it's the right dose?
Oh, pain management. You know, we've been doing such great work with simplified SPE lately. We've been focusing some energy on pain management. You know, it's a really complicated sample preparation to do. They're typically in urine, and there usually has to be some kind of hydrolysis step to break the conjugations of the glucuronide forms.
Wait, gluco what?
So your body will actually take the drug and it will conjugate different things to it so that it will deactivate it, and it'll also make it more soluble so that your body can get rid of it.
Oh, that makes sense. Sounds really complicated though.
It can be really time consuming, and that's the hard thing. You know, we're looking for ways to simplify that.
Kim, you don't need to be sad. This method doesn't have to be complicated. If you use Oasis MCX and the microelution plate technology, you can save a lot of time and effort with this analysis. Let me show you. So in a traditional method, we're doing more steps. In addition to that, we're doing these steps one by one by one. So we have to go ahead and take the samples and transfer them. Then we add our hydrolysis enzyme and buffer and go ahead and hydrolyze them or incubate them for a while. After that, we need to condition and equilibrate each sample cartridge one by one. We've got to transfer each sample to the cartridge, again, one by one. And then we do our washes. We do one wash, we do another wash, then we have to elute once again, one by one by one. We're doing each sample individually. Finally, when we're done, we need to take them over, evaporate all the solvent, reconstitute them in mobilize, and then do one final transfer into an autosampler vial before we can analyze the samples. Using this new method, we do all of our hydrolysis and incubation within the wells of the microelution plate. Then when that's done, we simply use vacuum and load them right onto the sorbent in the plate. We do our washes using a multi-channel pipette, so it's really, really fast, and then just directly elute into the autosampler plate. A simple dilution and we're ready to go. There's no evaporation, no reconstitution, and no more transferring of the samples. You know, Kim, the whiteboard doesn't really do it justice. I'll tell you what, let's do a side-by-side comparison. You do the one method over here, and I'll do the second method right here, and then we'll compare them and see how much better this is with excellent results.
Okay.
First, let's pipette our samples. All done?
Almost. You're a little faster than me. Okay.
Okay. Now, let's add our incubation reagent. Ready?
Ready.
All right, done?
Not yet.
All right, I'll wait.
Guess yours is going a little faster since you're doing a 96 well plate. Okay.
Okay. Now, let's incubate them. Okay, now the incubation's all done.
Okay, yep, so far it's taken about the same time for both of us.
All right, now we gotta load the samples. So, but first you need to condition and equilibrate all of your cartridges.
Give me a minute.
All right, now that that's all done, you need to load your samples onto the cartridges.
Well, what are you gonna do?
Remember, I already loaded mine, but I'll wait.
Okay.
All right, now that everything's loaded, we can go ahead and load them onto the sorbent. Ready?
Ready.
Let's go.
All right, Kim, now that everything's loaded, let's go ahead and do our washes, okay?
Okay.
All right, let's go.
All right.
Okay.
Okay.
This is gonna take me a little time.
So here we can see that we get excellent results even though we don't do any conditioning or equilibration. When we compare the traditional method with this new method, both of them have very, very good recoveries with very, very low variabilities. This carries through when we look at quantitative data. Whether we look at linearity or quality control data, we get excellent accuracies, all within 10% of our target values and very, very low relative standard deviations, meaning we have excellent accuracy and precision for every compound within this method.
Wow, that really saved a lot of time and effort. Can you do that with other Oasis sorbents and methods also?
You sure can. The key is to use a reproducible water-wettable sorbent, like for example Oasis Prime HLB and the microelution format. This allows you to directly load the samples onto the plate without any conditioning or equilibration. The microelution format lets us concentrate, and once again, we can avoid evaporation, reconstitution, saving time, effort, as well as any losses from those steps. For example, our friends down the hall use this with a protein works kit.
Wow, that wasn't so painful after all. My headache is gone, and yours can be too if you do this type of work. By using a water-wettable sorbent, one can save a lot of time and achieve very high and reproducible recoveries with this simple method. Great work for complicated samples. Check out the links below to learn more about all the different applications for Oasis MCX. And join us next time as we go behind the science to take a closer look at how we can make sure infant formula is safe. Let's do it for the children. We'll be right back.